Namo Buddhaya. Welcome back to Monks in the Morning from Colombo Dhamma Friends of Mahameonawa. The monks here are so happy to get the opportunity to spend time with you now. Yesterday, we learned three things that help us to get along with people. Do you remember what they are? Showing people loving kindness with our bodies, showing people loving kindness with our speech, and last, showing loving kindness with our minds. Well, today we'll learn three more things that help us to live in harmony, and these three things all have to do with sharing. Maybe your parents have told you for a long time to share things, but did you know that the Supreme Buddha also taught us to share? We'll learn about that today. We'll also chant the verses of loving kindness that start with the Pali words Ahang Avero Homi. If you don't know them, you can click on the show notes link and read along online. One of the best things that we can do to start the day is to go for refuge to the Buddha, the Dhamma, and the Sangha. Then, when we have difficulties or problems today, we can remember to think about what our teacher, the Supreme Buddha, has told us and try to find solutions that match with the Dhamma. Because the happiness that comes from following the Buddha's teachings lasts a long, long time, even into our next lives. Now let's take the refuges and the precepts.
Sadhu, sadhu, sadhu. Namo tassa bhagavato arahato Samma sambuddhasse Namo tassa bhagavato arahato Samma sambuddhasse Namo tassa bhagavato arahato Samma sambuddhasse Buddhaṃ saraṇaṃ gacchāmi Dhammaṃ saraṇaṃ gacchāmi Sanghaṃ saraṇaṃ gacchāmi Dutiyampi Buddhaṃ saraṇaṃ gacchāmi Dutiyampi Dhammaṃ saraṇaṃ gacchāmi Dutiyampi Sanghaṃ saraṇaṃ gacchāmi Tatiyampi Buddhaṃ saraṇaṃ gacchāmi Tatiyampi Dhammaṃ saraṇaṃ gacchāmi tatiyampi sanghaṃ saraṇaṃ gacchāmi sādhu sādhu sādhu
Say after me, I observe the precept of abstaining from killing beings. I observe the precept of abstaining from stealing. I observe the precept of abstaining from sexual misconduct. I observe the precept of abstaining from telling lies. I observe the precept of abstaining from taking intoxicating drinks and drugs
with the refuge of the noble triple gem. I observe these precepts for happiness in this life, for rebirth in heaven, to escape from the sufferings of samsara, may it help me, may it be a blessing. Sadhu, sadhu, sadhu.
Namo Buddhaya. Yesterday, we started to learn about ways that we can live in harmony with people, ways that we can live happily with each other, peacefully, without fighting or arguing. And I asked you to think if you could practice some of these. So do you remember what they were? Loving kindness that we practice with our bodies, loving kindness that we practice with our voice, and loving kindness that we practice with our mind. So were you able to practice some of those yesterday? Now, today, we're going to learn three more factors, three more ways that we can live together with people happily and peacefully. The fourth factor, the Supreme Buddha said, was that we share what we have. Now, you'll see that these second three factors, 4, 5, and 6, they're a little similar to the first three. But they're different, and it's important to understand them. So the fourth way that can help us live in harmony is when we share what we have with the people around us. The Supreme Buddha said, as monks, even share what people put into our alms bowl, right? That's the food that we eat, that even when we go to collect food, if another monk didn't get any food in his bowl, that we should absolutely share the food that's given to us. The Supreme Buddha spoke very highly of giving things to others. And we can understand that if we give things to the people around us, then we're going to live together happily, aren't we? If we do the opposite and we keep our things all to ourselves, we can understand how people may not be very happy to live with us, right? Maybe they're hungry or they need some paper or they need a toy, right? If we don't share those things, then they're going to be jealous of us. But if we always share our things with the people around us, then that ties us together, right? It feels like we're all on one team working through things together, that if we're short on food, then everybody's short on food, right? If we're short on money, then everybody's short on money. So when we share things with the people around us, then it helps us live in harmony. So the fifth factor is also about sharing, but it's sharing a very different kind of thing. The fifth factor is when we share the same good behavior, when we share the same sila. So I think you know the word sila means virtue or ethics, keeping the precepts. If we share the same precepts with the people around us, then we'll live together peacefully. So imagine you have to live with someone who kills and you don't kill. Is that going to be a comfortable way to live? No. You may see them killing even just insects, and we have this feeling like, I wish they didn't do that. I wish they'd give up killing. Right? Many children talk to me and say how at school, their friends or even their teachers, without even thinking twice, will kill insects. And it's very upsetting to them. So if we follow the same precepts, we'll live together peacefully and happily. If we're living with someone who steals, is that going to be a happy way to live? Of course not. We'll always be worried about locking our door and protecting our things. If we live with someone who lies to us, of course, that's not going to be a happy way to live. If we live with someone who uses alcohol and intoxicants, well, that's not a comfortable way to live when we're not doing those things. So the Supreme Buddha said that when we share the same precepts with the people around us, then we're going to live peacefully. When we have the same sila, the same virtue, the same good behavior, we'll live together peacefully. And the last one, the Supreme Buddha said that if we share the same right view with the people that we live with, that we'll live together peacefully. So I think a few episodes ago, we learned about what right view is. It's the belief that when we give things, there's good results, that giving is a very powerful action. We believe that when we do good things, we get good results. When we do bad things, we get bad results. We believe that our parents are a special kind of person to us, that they did a lot to help us. Even if we never met them, they did a lot to help us. And the actions that we do to them or don't do are very heavy, that we need to act in a good way to our parents. The belief that Supreme Buddhas have arisen in the world, all these things are part of right view. And the best kind of right view is when we understand the Four Noble Truths. When we understand what suffering is in the world, when we understand what causes suffering, our clinging and wanting things, when we understand that it's possible to give up that clinging, and when we follow the Noble Eightfold Path that leads to ending that suffering. If we share all these things with the people around us, we're going to live very peacefully. If we live with people who don't believe in rebirth, who don't believe in good and bad actions, it may not be easy to live with them. We might not have the same harmony. We might not have the same unity. The Supreme Buddha taught us that if we want to live peacefully together with others, we should share these three things. Do you remember the first thing that we should share? Our possessions. We should share our stuff with the people around us. What's the second thing that we should share? We should share our precepts. We should be following the same good behavior. And the third, we should share the same right view. We should have the Buddha's understanding of how the world works, what karma is, and to understand the Four Noble Truths. That when we have this shared, these three things with the people around us, and when we practice the three kinds of loving kindness, then we'll live very peacefully and very happily. So these days we might be stuck living with people, right? Even people that we like, but sometimes it can be difficult to live together. But if we think, okay, the people that I'm living with right now, they're sharing things with me. I should share things with them, right? If you're living with your parents right now, I think that they share many, many things with you. And you should share things with your parents too, and your brothers and your sisters, and the people that you're living with. You can see that because you share the same precepts and you share the same right view about the world with the Buddha, that you can live together peacefully and in harmony. So today, I'd like you to keep looking for ways that you can practice loving kindness with your body, with your speech, and with your mind. And I'd also like you to think about how you can share things with the people that you live with. Think about the benefits of sharing the same good precepts, and think about how lucky we are if we can live with people who have right view, the way that the Buddha understood the world. So, through the power of learning these ways of harmony, may we always have the chance to live together with good people, to live together with them without fighting, without jealousy, with trust and with love. And Through the power of this merit, may we soon experience the supreme bliss of Nibbana in this Gautama Buddha's dispensation. Sad, sad, sad. Namo Buddhaya. Metta Bhavana, chanting verses of loving kindness. Now we'll chant some ancient stanzas that help us to practice loving kindness. They start with Ahang Avero Homi, may I be free from anger. Maybe you've heard these before when you come to the monastery. The stanzas begin with wishing for our own happiness and then for the happiness of others. We think about different kinds of people and different places, eventually wishing that everyone in the world could be happy. Now let's chant together.
Ahang Avero Homi, may I be free from anger. Abhyapajjo Homi, may I be free from ill will. Anigo Homi, may I be free from mental and physical suffering. Sukhi attanam pariharami. May I look after myself and live happily. Ahang viyamaihang, as I am. Achari upajhaya, so may my noble mentors, Mata Pitaro, my mother and father, Hita Satta, friendly beings, Majjatika Satta, indifferent beings, Veri Satta, and unfriendly beings, Avera Hontu, be free from anger. Abhyapajja Hontu, be free from ill will. Anigha Hontu, be free from mental and physical suffering. Sukhi attanam pariharantu, may they look after themselves, live happily. Dukha munchantu, and be free from suffering. Yata laddha sampattito ma vigacchantu, may whatever they have gained not be lost. Kammasaka, all beings are owners of their kamma. Imasmin vihare, in this monastery, imasmin gocharagame, in this village, imasmin nagare, in this city, imasmin dipe, in this country, imasmin lanka dipe, in Sri Lanka, imasmin Jambudipe, in the Indian subcontinent, imasmin Chakkavale, in this universe, Issarajana, may prosperous leaders, Simattaka Devata, devas within these boundaries, sabbe satta and all beings, avera hontu, be free from anger. Abhyapajja hontu, be free from ill will. Anigha hontu, be free from mental and physical suffering. Sukhi attanam pariharantu. May they look after themselves, live happily. Dukha munchantu, and be free from suffering. Yata laddha sampathito ma vigacchantu. May whatever they have gained not be lost. Kammasaka, all beings are owners of their karma. Purattimaya disaya, in the eastern direction. Dakhinaya disaya, in the southern direction. Pachimaya disaya, in the western direction. Uttaraya disaya, in the northern direction. Purattimaya anudisaya, in the southeast direction. Dakhinaya anudisaya, in the northwest direction. Uttaraya anudisaya, in the northeast direction. Hettimaya disaya, in the direction below. Uparimaya disaya, and in the direction above. Sabbe satta, may all beings. Sabbe pana, all living beings. Sabbe bhuta, all creatures. Sabbe puggala, all persons. Sabbe attabhava pariyapanna, all individuals. Sabba ittiyo, all females. Sabbe purisa, all males. Sabbe ariya, all noble ones. Sabbe anariya, all worldlings. Sabbe deva, all deities. Sabbe manussa, all humans. Sabbe amanussa, all non-humans. Sabbe vinipatika, and all those in the four woeful plains. Averahuntu, be free from anger. Abhyapajjahuntu, be free from ill will. Anighahuntu, be free from mental and physical suffering. Sukhi attanam pariharantu. May they look after themselves, live happily. Dukha munchantu, and be free from suffering. Yata laddha sampattito ma vigacchantu. May whatever they have gained not be lost. Kammasaka, all beings are owners of their karma. Sabbe satta, සුකිනෝ බවන්තු May all beings live happily. Sabbe satta sukhino bhavantu. May all beings live happily. Sabbe satta sukhino bhavantu. May all beings live happily. Sadhu, sadhu, sadhu.
I'm so happy that we were able to spend time together today. We really hope that you learned something new, and we hope that you can use what you learned as you go about the rest of your day. If you ever have questions about things that you hear on the show, I'd like you to ask your parents or any wise people that you know who are familiar with the Supreme Buddha's Dhamma. You can even click on the show notes link and find out how to send a question to the monks here. We can try to answer it on the show. Especially, right now, if you're feeling afraid about the things going on in the world, it's good to have someone that you can trust to give you advice that matches with the Buddha's teachings. Now let's share merits. Today, in this short time, we've done many acts of wholesome behavior that lead to good results in the future. You've gone for refuge, taken the precepts. We've listened to a sermon on ways of getting along with the people that we live with. And we've recited these verses and practiced loving-kindness meditation. And also, I'm sure that you've done lots of other good things today, even if it's early in the morning. So we think about all of these things, and we wish, may all heavenly beings, may our teacher, Lokasoma Hongsa, may all of our teachers and parents and friends and relatives, may they all rejoice in this merit. May they have good health, long life, strength, beauty, happiness. May they soon experience for themselves the supreme bliss of Nibbana in this Gautama Buddha's dispensation. Sadhu, sadhu, sadhu. Namo Buddhaya.